My name is Franco Rotoli from the Solidworks training team. In this video, I'm going to show you how to control, study, and animate assembly motion using Solidworks Mate Controller. Let's get started. I need to verify and demonstrate the range of motion and functionality of this robot arm. There are angle and limit mates already assigned to the various components. Obviously, I can easily click and drag the parts around. But because of the multiple degrees of freedom, it's difficult to get a good idea of how this will move. Mate Controller to the rescue. The Mate Controller works with many standard and limit mates, as well as some advanced mates, such as path and slot mates. Basically, any mate with a numerical value representing distance. To activate the Mate Controller, simply select it from the Insert menu. Or you can add it to the Assembly toolbar. Check out my earlier video on toolbar customization on how to do that. You can choose individual mates to control from the Flyout Feature Manager tree, or click Select All Supported Mates. Renaming your mates before this step is a very good idea. The selected mates get added to the dialog, along with their current values. Limit mates have a slider, and standard distance or angle mates have a spin box. The mates will be updated in the order shown. You can reorder them here. As you move the sliders or type in values, the assembly instantly updates. You can also make a mate driven by clicking here. This will allow you to drag the assembly to its position in the graphics area and update the values accordingly. All the other mates are locked when one or more mate is set to driven, giving you precise control over which mates move and which don't. Positions are like steps in the process. When you're satisfied with the values of the mates, click the Add Position button. You can rename your positions as you see fit for your process. I'll keep them as numbered positions. As you add more positions, they get listed in the animation window below. You can adjust the duration of the animation of that position right here. Once you have all your positions and timing, calculate the animation. To update any position, simply select it from the dropdown and modify the mates. When you're done, click the Update Position button. You can also save positions as configurations. Just choose the position and click Add Configuration. To save the animation so you can show off your amazing SolidWorks skills, it's only a couple of clicks away. Clicking the green check adds a Mate Controller feature to your assembly tree. By clicking the feature, you can instantly move your assembly to any of the positions you created. As a side note, you're not limited to a single Mate Controller feature. If your assembly moves in different ways for different applications, you can add more than one Mate Controller feature to capture that. Thanks for watching. If you found this tip helpful, click the link in the description below for more great SolidWorks content.